Hey there, folks. Tip here, Stupid Gardener. Welcome back. Thanks for stopping by. Well, the day has finally arrived when we can start planting our raised garden bed. And it is a perfect day to do that because it is a nice overcast day. So perfect time to get our tomato plants in the ground here in zone 7B in North Carolina. So stay tuned and we'll plant some tomatoes.
Okay, so we're in our garden bed. We're gonna get these tomatoes planted. And one thing I just wanted to go over again, I think we've covered this before, is that this garden, I got it covered with wood chips. We do not plant in the wood chips. We scrape away all the wood chips and get down to where our soil is. These wood chips are just there to protect the soil, hold in moisture. It's gonna be breaking down over time and feeding our soil. So, but we do not plant in the wood chips. You dig below it and just plant below. So let's get a hole dug in here. And I tell you what, this is great soil. Look how dark and rich that is. And this is all compost. And this goes down probably about at least 6-7 inches or so. And so this is a determinate tomato. And what you want to do when you plant these is first check and make sure that there's no blooms on here and there's no like little tomatoes coming in. And if they are, just go ahead and pick those off, because you want this plant just to be concentrating on growing and growing leaves and getting green. You do not want any tomatoes coming on it now, because that root system will just be feeding that tomato and it'll really stunt the growth of your tomato plant. So make sure you go through it. And if you see any, you know, small green tomatoes or anything like that, just to pull them right off. And also the next thing you want to do, you want to trim off all these lower leaves here. Because when we plant these tomatoes, we want to make sure that we're planting them down deep. And you just want that main stem growing. So let me cut this one here off. Because all along this tomato plant, you'll see you've got these little hairs there. Those are roots. So, and you want this to have a great root system here. So you really want to plant that, you know, down in there deep. So let's get this thing in the ground here. Throw in a little peat moss here in the bottom. And I got some nice freshly screened compost I'll throw in there too. And I got some water here. Okay, let's get some water here on the bottom. You really want to make sure you have a lot of water here on the bottom here to feed this root system, because this plant is going to go through a little bit of a shock being transplanted and everything. I've let these sit outside for a couple of days, so they're pretty much hardened off to the weather. And you just want to get this down in there. Get it well below the surface, and then put that compost and soil back around here. And sometimes you think, oh, you know, you're cutting away too much and everything, but really, when you see this thing in another month or so, and it has a nice strong root system, it's really gonna be growing, because you want that root system in there, you know, to really concentrate on getting out, having a nice firm foundation for this plant, and have it feeding these leaves, getting it nice and green and getting it nice and big before it starts blooming and bearing fruit. And you just wanna soak it in real good here. And this is the perfect day to do this. Because it's overcast, we're going to be getting some showers here this morning. It may clear off this afternoon, but I will come back in and really give this a, if we don't get that much rain, I will really give this a good watering tonight and really get it going. And this is determinate tomato. It's like a bush tomato. It's just going to grow for a determinate amount of time. The indeterminate, which we are going to plant, they're going to grow a lot taller, and you can put those on a stake and do them vertical and really get them up high. But these ones here will just grow to a determined length, and then they will stop fruiting. I had real good luck with these here last summer, planting these in the garden. We were pulling tomatoes off, gosh, well into September and October on determinate plants. So that's pretty good. So, and we got, like I said, we have some great soil here. So hopefully this will get up and going. I'll put a nice cage around here and really get this to grow. And as this grows, we'll go over pruning these, getting off the suckers and different things like that. Okay, when you're done watering it in, just take all the wood chips and put them back around your plant here, because that'll, like I said, continue to hold the moisture in. You don't want the wood chips right up against the stem of your plant, but just leave a little area there where it'll grow, where you can water into. And this will just keep all that moisture in, and it'll keep the sun from cooking up this soil here. We get a lot of hot sun here in North Carolina. And that way there, when it rains and when it when you water, you won't have anything splashing back up on your leaves and rotting your leaves. And remember, when you water from the bottom, not from the top, trying to keep the leaves as dry as possible. It's okay if rainwater gets in here, but these wood chips will stop that splash from coming back up and getting onto your leaves. Okay, I'm gonna continue to get the rest of these determinate tomatoes in. Yesterday I planted a whole row of cherry tomatoes. I think I planted like 7 or 8 of those yesterday. And I got some broccoli over there that I put in. And I'm gonna be putting in some indeterminate tomatoes back up in the corner there, hopefully maybe tomorrow or next weekend. And I also got a whole row of bell peppers that I'm gonna be putting in. I got squash and I got some zucchini I'm gonna be putting in. And also I'm gonna plant by seed some cucumbers up there in the back. As well as some pole beans on this trellis that I have over here. So hopefully I'll be able to get that all in today. So I'm gonna have to get rolling on that. So if you are not a subscriber, please stop what you're doing, hit that subscribe button, and just follow along with us for the summertime and see what comes in this garden this year. I got a big expansion this year, so it'll be interesting to see exactly what we get out of here on our first year of this expansion. So I want to thank everyone for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button, put a comment down below. So this is Tip from The Stupid Gardener. Everyone take care. God bless everybody. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and follow along for the summer.